Welcome to our channel, Peppy Family. Today I'm gonna discuss about some of the ways to find the cheap airline tickets, and I'm gonna use Google Flights to show you how to do that. Okay, let's get started. Open your favorite browser and type Google Flights and select the first URL. And this gets you to the Google Flights website. So here you have a few options, like whether you want to do round trip, one way, or multi-city. And then number of adults, you could add this by clicking on this plus symbol. For now, I just stick to one adult. Children, infants on lap. When done, just click done. And you have one more drop down to select the class, business, first class, etc. Now you choose the source and destination. Let's say I'm traveling from San Francisco and I want to go to Paris. So type Paris, it's going to give you all the airports. So you could just select all airports, that's fine too. And the travel dates. Let me choose Tuesday because generally I find low fares on Tuesdays, so I'll go with August 27th, and let's say I want to return back on September 17th. I want to go for really good vacation. Cool. Now based on the search criteria, it's gonna give us few results, right? And the first set of results are best departing flights. It categorizes best based on the airlines and the travel time, lowest price, and the number of stops. It also shows some other departing flights. Let's choose these are actually of same price, pretty much same price. So but since these are like non-stop flights, I always prefer non-stop flights. So let me just go ahead and book this flight. These are of the same price, so I'll just go ahead and book this one. Cool, you could use this drop down to see the information about your flight, like the in-flight services, Wi-Fi, and legroom, and then the travel time. And based on the flight's history, they will say how often it's delayed by. So here it's 30 plus minutes delay. Same thing here. And you have fare options, like you wanna just go with $0. Adding nothing on top of our price. So here you get a free carry-on, and you have to pay for the checked baggage, which you could do later as well, at the counter or by visiting the airline website. If you want to do right away, you could add a free check. This is not free actually, so we are paying $120 more, for which they're going to give you a check baggage and some other facilities, conveniences. So for now, I'll just go ahead with basic economy. And under booking options, you have a lot many booking options, but I prefer, and also I recommend going and booking directly with the airlines. So here I click select, and this one is gonna route us to the airline, which is here in our case United Airlines. So it's routed us here, and we could pay here. Or the other options is Google also, like we could directly book on the Google as well. It's not gonna route us anywhere but Google, so. But I just prefer to book on the airline. So cool. But again, guys, $915 is too much, and it doesn't fit in my budget. So let's see if I could, find flights for little cheaper price. So what are the other options I have? Let's see. The first thing you could do is you could look at the date grid. So click on the date grid, and it will show us the all possible prices in the nearby dates. We are traveling on 27th, so it gives like 3 days earlier and then 3 days after. And And if you compromise on your travel dates, you're gonna get for a little cheaper. Let's say if you wanna travel on Sunday, you're okay to travel on Sunday 2 days earlier, and you return on the same day. So the way you calculate is just draw a L from here, which shows you the departure date, L, right? And the arrival date, or like a cross, right? It shows you the departure and arrival. Let's say if you select this 794, what is the departure and arrival? Let's do a L here, which means you're departing on Monday 26th and coming back on Friday, September 20th. Now you got how to select this one. So let me go. I'm okay with, you know, going a couple of days ahead and, you know, coming back on Tuesday, because I'm getting a couple of $100 less. Again, it's your own preference. So I'm just showing you how to find the cheapest ticket. So once this turns blue, just close this one. And okay, you get some options to book. Right? Go ahead and select this, and then 702, yeah. And you follow the similar procedure. But what if you wanted to do some other options? I mean, you wanna, let's say, you still, let's say, same date, but what are other ways to find? Let's say if you have plenty of time to try to decide on travel, and it's not urgent, and you're in the initial steps of planning your vacation, then I would suggest seeing this price graph, because it gives you an idea of what the price looks like in various months. So now, right now in August, it's like very expensive, right? It's all, on an average, it costs $800 to $900. So what if I postpone my travels for October? Wow, it's way far cheaper than what we have right now. It's half of the price of the one which we have right now. So I think, you know, traveling in October, in fact November, is a good idea. Oh, look here, it's a little bumpy here in December again. So yeah, based on this, like, if you have, you're very flexible, you are just in the initial stage of planning, go for this. And what is the other way to look for cheaper flights, right? So nearby airports, that's one of the things. So if you wanted to know what are the nearby airports, you see it's giving some indication. Fly from Oakland for $629, that is way cheaper. Cool. So I'm gonna look nearby airports both at the source and destination, right? When I click on nearby airports, it's showing me the airports in Paris. That's fine. So because, yeah, so these are the nearby airports, but look at the cost. They're almost like, they're more than, or yeah, more than the what we have set the airport at. So in some cases, like, the nearby airports actually are cheaper than flying to the straight destination, but in our case it's not. But so I just leave it to that. How about the source? I know Oakland is closer to San Francisco. If I just select Oakland, oh, see, the price dropped from $915 to $629. That's pretty impressive. And this flight is non-stop too, which is good. So if I select this, and even the return is non-stop, I'll select this. Cool. And you know, it has the same free carry-on policy and price for checked baggage. So I could just go ahead and you know, book with the website, airline website. Okay, let's take another example. Let's book a flight from San Francisco to Baltimore, BWI. So on the following dates. And if you look here, the cheapest flight we are getting is for $833 round trip. So how could we see if we have any other options? So in the Google, in the source, just click on this box. So you're gonna see a little drop down here on the same source airport. Click on that drop down. After that, click on this plus symbol. As soon as you click this, all the check boxes will appear for the nearest airports, along with the number of miles from the source airport and the price at those airports, right? So I see like San Jose airport is like 39 miles from San Francisco, and the price is lower. So I'm gonna I actually prefer this one. So click on this one, checkbox this, and then click right. Okay, I'm gonna do the similar thing at the destination airport. So click this drop down, and I see this airport DCA is Ronald Reagan Washington Airport is like 18 miles, not too far, and the price is $496. So I'm gonna click this plus symbol, and you're gonna get these check mark boxes. I'm gonna check mark this and click OK. Oh, you see, the price went down from 800 change to 496. That's really a good deal, right? So it's like almost like 300 savings. So this is one of the ways to book flight, look for cheap flight. So as usual, you select this, and then of course there will be a mix and match. So mix and match of airlines, and you select this one, and you follow the remaining steps as usual as shown before. If you have plenty of time, you're planning your travel way ahead, then there is an option to track your flights. For this particular itinerary, you could track the prices. Just click here. When it turns blue, which means your flights are already being tracked. And whenever there is a price change, let's say this $629 goes to $400 or $500, you're gonna get an email. To which email? This is like whichever you're logged in right now. You have to sign into the Google your Gmail account, so that you have to sign into your Gmail account and then do the search. That way you get an email to this Gmail account. So I did this in the past, and let's see how the results will be. Like, I did track the prices for Paris on August 8th. So when I looked at that time, it was that price was 564, but I got a notification email saying, okay, my price dropped and now it is 473. At one point on August 13, I got a notification saying it's like 413. Maybe this is a good time to book, right? I could have saved like $150 here. So you could do something like this. Again, if your plans are flexible. And let's see, let's find some more ways. If you come to the bottom, there is a map option. So just click on explore destinations. You see your source is San Francisco, Oakland. You could always add more airports, like maybe 5 or so. You could add up to 5 airports, I guess. Okay. And make sure like those are not too far from your home. And even if you don't know, like if you're bored at work and if you want to choose a random vacation and you don't know the destination, I would say use this map, right? So it's gonna, and you're on a budget at the same time, then I suggest using this map, so, right? So for this time, let's say if you want a vacation in United States, so where you wanna, you could find the prices to various cities. You could actually use this minus and plus symbol to fine grain the cities. Oh, maybe I could go to Miami, or maybe I could just go to Denver, you know. Or, well, Las Vegas is like $75 round trip. So this is one of the ways you could still fine grain. As long as you click this plus symbol here, you could fine grain all the cities. So this is a good start to, I mean, for people who are planning their random vacation with a budget and they really don't know where they're gonna go. So I think this is a good tool, right? All right, so I could apply the same thing to our earlier search, Paris. Let me type Paris here, all airports. Now, oh, hold on, sorry. You should be able to find Paris in the map here, right? This is Paris area, right? You could pretty much find anything in the world, any city in the world. So if I expand this region, so this is Paris, right? So for this date, I'm getting a ticket for $629. So Europe, you know, it's like you could travel anywhere in Europe to any, I mean, in between these countries, in a train, right? So they are really close by. So if you are open to traveling in nearby countries, and if you're getting a less price, then maybe that's also a best option, right? So you could use this Google Maps. You just like scroll and that's it. You just drag it and it's gonna give you the prices for various cities. So in this case, looks like if I travel, at this point looks like Paris is the only place where I'm getting lowest price, right? And if you wanna travel towards Italy, Milan, right? So you're getting a price for $667. So, and Rome $676, right? So this is one of the ways to see the tickets on the fly, and when you're really not sure where to travel, or just to compare the ticket between various places, right? The advantage of this is like you don't have to end up typing the destination each time. You just drag and you find the destination. All right. Sometimes, rather than booking the round trip, booking one ways to nearby places is much cheaper, based on your adjustments and your travel plans and all. So, let's say if you are traveling to Yellowstone from San Francisco, and on these dates, and if the round trip might cost you like $400. And let's say your plan is as such, like you could go to Salt Lake City, which is, and then explore many places on the way to Yellowstone, and if you have some planned activities in between Salt Lake City and Yellowstone, like you could cover a city called Jackson, a town called Jackson. So in that case, you could look something like this. You could go one way from San Francisco to Salt Lake City on the same date, which is September 21st. So, and you got a flight for $59, okay? And once you're done with the trip at Yellowstone, you could look for the nearest airport at Yellowstone. You could do this by just a drop down. Salt Lake City, which is 271 miles too far away, but this is where we just landed, right? So, and the other one is 77 miles. Which is Bozeman. So let's look tickets from Bozeman to San Francisco on the same date, which is October 4th. So this is $169. So $169 and then $59. So nearly $220. So $220 and compared to $220 compared to $405 is much cheaper. So you could plan something like that. So I just wanted to let you know that rather than round trip, sometimes if you can do some adjustments, and if you are comfortable with a few changes, then flying to nearby cities one way could be much cheaper, and you could sometimes you could just save half of the money. Thank you for watching, guys. Please like and subscribe our channel Pepe Family for more videos. Bye bye.